Just like with our API view, we need to map our view set to a URL so that we can actually use it in the browser. Django, or the Django REST framework, has a special router class that can be used to automatically set up the different routes for our URL to our view set. This is one of the advantages of using a view set over an API view, because we can make use of the Django REST framework's router class. So let's add a router class for our hello view set. Load up Atom and locate the URLs file in the Profiles API app. It's very important that you choose the URLs file in the Profiles API app and not the one in the Profiles project, because we need to change the URL file for our API. We're going to start by adding a couple more imports to the top of the URLs file. The first one is the include import. So let's type from django.conf.urls import include. The next import we're going to add is the default router class. That comes from the REST framework routers module. So let's type from REST underscore framework dot routers import default router. Okay, so now that we've added the imports, let's go ahead and create our router. Just above the URL patterns, create a new variable called router and assign it to a default router object. Underneath that, we're going to register a new URL with our router that points to our hello view set. We do this by typing router.register, and then in the first parameter, we're going to add a string that says the name of our API. So this is what we want to call it. So we want to call it hello-viewset, all lowercase with no spaces. The second parameter is going to be the name of the view set that we want to assign to this router, or the one that we want to register. So let's type views.helloViewset to register our hello view set. Finally, we need to give it a base name. So we're going to add the parameter base underscore name equals, and again, we're going to call it hello-viewset. Okay, so now we've registered our router, we just need to assign it to a URL. So what we can do here is we can add a new line underneath the hello view URL and create a new URL. But this time we're going to assign just a blank string to the regular expression. So type R, then blank string, and then comma, and then we're going to include, we're going to use the include to add our router URLs. So include router.urls. This way, our router object can create the URLs for us. And that's why we need the include, to include the URLs that the router automatically generates. The reason we add a blank string here is because we want Django, if it can't match a URL, or if any of the URLs don't match, then it's going to feed it into our router. So it will check the ones that we've specified first. If it doesn't match any of them, then it will check all of the ones in the router. Okay, so save the file. That's how you configure the URLs file to work with a default router. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next lesson.